Now on 4, a new series looking at a range of personal services. This week, canine comfort is the order of the day in Give a Dog a Home.
Hello, can I help you? I'm calling about your advertisement.
How can I help?
Say hello to Toto, beloved pet of the fox family from Elton. Toto is a 7-year-old pedigree Yorkshire Terrier, sort of.
He wasn't quite up to scratch. He wasn't totally a reject, but he wasn't quite a proper pedigree. And they brought him in and put this little scrap, this tiny little thing, on our settee. And he kind of unfolded his ears. His ears were too big and they're slightly in the wrong position for Yorkshire Terriers. A cup of tea.
Where is?
The foxes are going on holiday, and so is Toto. But not together. Other arrangements have been made for him.
Ideally, we would have liked to take him away with us, but we just can't. It's just not fair to him. He gets too distressed and upset in the car.
Some doggy folk never go away because they won't put their best friend into kennels. Marilyn Lewis, owner of Old Scamp, recognised a gap in the market and, for £8 a day, about a pound more than the cost of kennels, now provides a personal service for canines, which has proved to be a nice little earner.
Good afternoon, home from home.
Oh, hello, yes. I've seen your advert in the paper.
Yes.
And I'm inquiring about, I've got a boxer called Oscar.
Right.
And he's never been away from home before.
Okay, basically, we have a register of dog carers throughout the South East, and they're people who are vetted by us and come onto our books, and they're at home during the day.
Yeah, well, we'll do it together. Is he going to poo away in the home?
No.
No.
What a question.
And then you have to give details.
He's trying. Yes.
No.
Is your dog likely to jump onto furniture?
Yeah.
Describe your dog's level of obedience.
Not very high. I say...
No, not very high.
I say just...
He's not trained, is he?
It's over normal. Over normal, I say.
Right, whine.
But occasionally.
But very occasionally.
No. Not very occasionally.
No, only when desperate.
Shut up, Rose.
What do you think?
No.
I don't think he does.
Oh, I don't think he does.
He does scratch
the
back door.
Don't talk to me. Talk to Mum as well. Just say only when desperate.
I don't think he does.
What about the soaking in occasionally and never?
Everybody's got to have their say. They're going to think we're mad. Occasionally.
I don't think he does occasionally.
Back door.
Robert, Mum. Oh, it's about time. What have you got? Pie mash. Bit wet.
Mother and son, Rose and Fred Hill, have been on Marilyn's books for 18 months and, like all carers, are paid £5 a day. The Hills used to share their home with a Yorkshire Terrier just like Toto, and they still pine for Peanuts, who passed away 3 years ago.
Peanuts was, very dear to me, you know, and I don't think I could cope with another dog. And it's the fact that I couldn't afford to have another dog, even if I wanted one. But having the other dogs, like dog minding, you know, it's just right, because I have all different dogs. And I don't have to worry about the price of looking after them, because the owners fetch everything they need. And I can love the dogs at the same time, you see.
Taking on other people's dogs, at the end of the day, they go home. And like, it's a bit sad to see them go, yes, but another day another dog will be here, so it's not too upsetting. And plus, we're getting over the fact that Peanuts has died.
How describe Oscar's level of obedience? What do you think he's like?
Not very good.
I don't think he's very good.
His character's funny.
He's funny, isn't he?
He's hypo. Very hypo.
No, I can't write that down, can
he's
I?
He's mad.
He's mad as well. What's he just had with us that we like?
Cup of tea.
Cup of tea and dinner.
Cup of tea.
Yes. Cup of tea.
He barks at the Hoover.
He barks at the Hoover. Why do you think he does that?
He tries to bite it and jump over it.
Oh, we can write that down, can't we? Barks at the hoover.
And bites.
And bites it, shall we? Okay, then.
Some people think 78-year-old widow and carer Wynne Bellingham is a bit odd. She isn't, but she is psychic, hence her nickname, Wynne the Witch. Wynne, happy to join in with the joke, named her house Witch Wynne's and filled it with appropriate knick-knacks. Well, that's just a big laugh. But caring for other people's dogs is something she takes very seriously.
I prefer the medium to the larger dogs. You've got somebody to sort of see rather than the little dog to trip over. You can see where the larger dogs are. They need a lot of exercise, and so do I. So I combine the two. And I think they're just more company.
Wynne is one of Marilyn's original carers.
I like having the dogs here rather than thinking of them go to kennels, because when the animals go into the kennels, it's like putting them in a prison. They're in cages, they're away from normal household surroundings and carpets. Whereas when the dogs come to me, it's a one-to-one service.
The day of delivery for Toto and Oscar.
I'm a bit apprehensive. I'm wondering whether he'll pine. I don't know, I'm just wondering whether he'll sort of try and get out. Because that's his normal trick here. I think if anything ever happened to him, we'd be devastated.
All those treats, yeah. Sure you could be sick if you eat till then. I do want that towel and shampoo as well, Nicholas.
Right. When I have the dogs to stay, I take this downstairs because it's a nice comfy rug
for the dogs to lay on, other than their own baskets that they bring in. So it'll have to have a good shake in the garden in case there's any other dog hairs left on it.
Whoops. So Wynne, who prefers big dogs, gets Toto, and the Hills, who love Yorkies, have been landed with Oscar. Funny how dogs, rather like real children, have a tendency to let you down and disgrace themselves at exactly the moment you want them to make a good impression.
Let's go in. Yeah. Just go in and I'll go and clear it all up. Charming.
Yes, we've boarded that up this morning so that he couldn't get through, and I've also boarded up the back gate.
Oh, yeah, I can see that. I don't want to lose him.
Don't want to lose him on the first day.
The reason he's been sick, he's had a bag of cream toffees. Which
we let him have that anyway.
He got them himself. Also fruit pastels.
Oh no.
He's had a big, and I mean a big bag.
So he's going to bring all that up, is he?
Yeah, well he's just brought one lot up, hasn't he? So, sorry.
These are his treats. But I think I've gone a little bit overboard here with them.
How often does he have them?
Well, once a day. Once a day. Yeah, the big ones.
Goodbye, Oscar.
Okay. Come on then.
What, is Oscar staying here now?
Yeah, he's got two. Looks a bit dejected now, doesn't he? Come on in. Otherwise I'll stay. Okay, have you got him?
Yeah, we've got him.
Have a nice holiday.
See you
later.
See you later.
Strange. I do feel a bit
snivelly. Come on then, Toto. Bring your toy. Come.
Come.
breed Susie the Shih Tzu, officially owned by Sylvie Barlow, but doted on by husband Bill, who's a bit of a softie. The Barlows are off to Tunisia, and Susie's getting all tarted up before going to a carer. Oh, yeah.
Bill is soft on her, he treats her like a baby. Feeds her biscuits and any goodies that he's having, he's got to share them with her. Gives her his toast and anything he's eating, he's feeding her as well.
I'll give a bit. If I have a biscuit, she has a biscuit.
You know, but I don't believe in that, because you can't overfeed them and give them too much of the sweet stuff. And
oh, yeah, but she's not overweight, is she?
No.
Susie will be taken into the home of the Whites. Jean White isn't that keen on dogs, but tolerates them for the sake of her husband, Dave.
I know it's a waste of time to try and get a few stained up from the last dog before the next one comes.
Dave has always been a bit of a one for the ladies, and it dawned on Jean, the third Mrs. White, that if he's got a dog to play with, it keeps his mind off other things.
My problem in life is that I came from a very, very loving family. My mother and father were very, very loving, and my mother was always cuddling me and kissing me as a child. And as I've grown up into a cuddly, kissy sort of life. I mean, I'm always grabbing hold of Jean and all this. Well, having a dog sort of alleviates part of this, because Jean will tell you what I'm like when I'm out.
Women of all ages respond to it.
All ages, yeah.
Yeah,
and the young ones.
Oh, and the young ones, yes.
But is he prepared for this little lady?
Sit.
Well, she sleeps on this. It's her beanbag cushion by the side of the bed.
Does.
But in the night, you will try to get your legs down, and she's plopped herself on the bottom of the bed. Because I'm sure he'd sooner have her in bed than me sometimes.
Yeah, it's not very nice, is it?
This is a flea spray. Not that there's any fleas here, but in case there's any eggs or anything that are hatched out from the previous dog. This stuff here is a Pet Behave spray, which I spray on the corners of the chairs and round here.
What did you say?
Hello, my med dog.
Hello.
I've got a dog for you.
Hello. Well, she sleeps on her bed at the side of our bed, but in the night she'll jump on the bed.
Oh, well, we won't ever.
No, that's right.
But we
don't either. I can't.
Can't sleep on the top of the stairs.
No, just put her bed up there and she'll know where her bed is.
All right.
She'll be fine.
Okay.
Yeah, she'll be fine.
Yeah, we.
Because when she stays at my son, she does
have got fleas, but.
No, she has.
If a dog comes here, they've got fleas, we get them up in the bedroom.
Well, that's right.
Know,
that's right.
So we just don't take a chance.
She certainly hasn't got fleas.
No. All right. I think she's settling in all right, don't you?
Yeah.
She's friendly.
Well, if you're friendly to her, she's friendly back.
Yeah.
You know, and she'd do anything for her. She's really good.
You're going to be all right with Uncle Dave, are you, baby?
Anyone that's nice to her, she just worships her.
Yeah, she'll be all right with Uncle Dave,
Lanzarote.
Hello, is that Fred? Hello, it's Linda. Oscar, all right, how are you? When did he stop being sick then? Oh, that's good. How's he behaving?
Come on. You think he's enjoying himself?
Now look this way, Pat. I want to paint your ears.
They're big fat wood pigeons, aren't they? That's a good girl. Chase the pigeons away.
$2.99, please.
You're not attacking those gnomes, are you? You great bully.
Where's mine?
It really breaks the ice when you've got an animal with you. It's nice, and I think it's not only nice for myself, but for other people that are possibly living on their own. If you've got a dog with you, people immediately say hello as though you're an old friend. I'm quite pleased to see you.
Yeah,
Seems to be interested in the bowls. You're going to take it up when you go up.
I understand the feelings of being separated. I had to leave home as a youngster and it's quite a hard strain on me. I was moved to a children's home by my mother and father. They actually told me to go there with the help of a social worker because I had troubles living with my parents and going to school. I just wouldn't go to school. That's why I understand the dogs, because when the owners go off on their holidays and the dogs come to us, they're going through exactly the same thing as we, as I went through. You know, as if they've been dumped.
Since we've been looking after the dogs, me and Freddie have got on much better.
Good boy, Oscar. Your mummy's going to be pleased, isn't she, eh?
When we're on our own, it doesn't seem that much interest in each other, you know, but when the dogs come, it's a different story because we both take care of the dogs.
Should we do some training? Every time I've spoken to a dog, they've listened. They've always agreed with me by licking me or by waggling their tail. Stay. I've always talked to them about my troubles. Stay. I was talking to Oscar last night and he sort of sat there and looked at me with his little worried eyes in the way of saying, well, don't worry about it, things will become better. Good boy.
I don't think I need to ask if you're happy, do I? That silly little grin on your face. Look at it.
Come on in. Come on in.
Toto, come and meet my friends.
Toto,
thank you,
Dirty. Oh,
he's shy. Shall we find out which table we're on? Yes. Pat, shall we? Thanks, dear. Which one did you say, Kathy? Thanks, dear.
Now, look here, you. I'm in charge here, do you understand? You mustn't bite.
You've got an extra helper today, Toto.
Well, we need some help.
Toto.
What's his name? Toto.
She's sweet. Lovely. Yeah. His parents have gone on holiday.
Can I have your attention, please? The first question is, which breed of dog is named after a Mexican province?
No, I didn't.
Name Dorothy's dog in The Wizard of Oz.
She's said that about six times.
You've got to go up to bye-byes, haven't you? Land your beanbag and go to bye-byes like a good little girl. Hey, got no mummy, no daddy. She's all alone in the world. Poor little soul. And shall I sing to you? Someone else's baby, someone else's little pride and joy, someone else's baby, someone's little pocket of joy. Did you like that one, eh? Did you like that one?
Time to say goodnight. Time to say goodbye.
I should be listening for his little jingle of his collar. Thinking he's behind me somewhere. What is it you want? You want? What is it you want? I haven't got any other dogs booked at the moment.
Kiss me, Tootsie, goodbye. Kiss me, Tootsie, goodbye. The choo-choo train that takes you away from me. You know how sad it makes me.
Kiss me, Tootie, and then
do it all over again. Like a little brown rat.
Watch for the mail. I'll never fail. You don't get a letter, then you'll know I'm in jail.
clean little boy, ready to go home to your mummy and daddy.
Say goodbye.
Who's this?
I think his little head looking over his face. Where have we been? Where have we been, Toto?
Did you sit still, Toto?
Who's that? Oh, it's beautiful.
And you recognise him, do you?
Oh, it's lovely.
Oh, look at them.
Hello. There. Hey, bitch. Hey. There. You've been a good girl. Have you? You've been a good girl. You want to go home?
It's a shame that he's got to go, really. You know, I'd like to keep him myself. But he's got to go back home to his own owners. What a shame.
Bye-bye, Toto. Bye-bye. You coming again?
Bye-bye.
He doesn't care, look. He's just going off, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Bye. Thanks ever so much for my present. I'm thrilled to be.
Yeah, lovely. Thanks.
Bye.
I'll let for them and have a look like him, love
you. Oh, no, he's a lovely dog. No, but... it's this business, isn't it, really?
What, I'm going on?
Yeah.
Next week, a nurse who's maternally yours. A personal service for babies at 8:30 next Thursday.